Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. So today we're going to see about AlexNet. So what all advancement they proposed in AlexNet that we're going to see. So basically the depth of the network, they create high depth. So you can see this is the AlexNet architecture. So the depth is high. The depth I'm speaking about the convolution layer. So there are various convolution layer that have been implemented here. So as you can see, the depth is high. So the depth is high is basically it is used to increase, it will extract the better features of the images, right? So okay. Again, the kernel size, and the kernel size also are very different. So usually in LeetNet it was used 5x5 in every layer, but in AlexNet there are different kernel size, 11x11, 3x3 or 3x3 or, and there are various sizes of kernels have been implemented here. The padding, the new concept padding also introduced in that. So I'll while describing the architecture, I'll say what is padding and how we are going to do the padding and all. So padding also here, you can see the padding also been implemented here. Overlap pooling. So in LeetNet actually average pooling was used. Here max pooling has been introduced in FIDI, which is overlapping. So what is overlapping, I will tell you how it is going to helpful. And one more activation layer, TANS has been introduced in 1998 in LeetNet, but here ReLU activation function has been used. And one more concept, new dropout has been also used in the particular architecture. And local response normalization, it is one of the normalization method also used, so I'll tell you about that. And one new thing, the new technology, that is data augmentation also used. So data augmentation is nothing but it is introduced due to check the various variances in the input. So it will help you to overcome overfitting. So basically data augmentation is nothing but it will try to rotate your image, flip your image, and try to do different possible scenarios applied in that particular image, so that your model will learn various variances of your image in the backward propagation. Okay, so let's see about the architecture. So here, as you can see, in the LeetNet we have actually taken the black and white, like gray image. So it is actually 3D image. So 3D image is nothing but 3D image is nothing but RGB. So you know, all images possible in the world, it can be referred to as RGB. This is R, this is G, and this is, you can say, this is B. So red, green, blue. So this can be converted to RGB, and this particular convolution layer actually has been used, which is 11x11 with stride 4, and such 96 kernels has been used. So how it is gonna use in that particular 3D? So let's see. So this is nothing but 11x11 kernels. So it will be implemented in R, in G, in B. Then what happened, we will just do the summation of 3, and that particular summation will give us the final output. This is the final output of the kernel, image extraction it will give. So this particular 11x11 kernel will be implemented in here first, then in here in RGB, then we'll get the final pixel value. So after the final action, actually internally what it does, it takes all the values, and that It takes all these values and add it up and pass it to an activation layer. That you can say ReLU. It pass it to the ReLU, and after passing to the ReLU, the value will be put in the here with addition of some biases. So addition of some biases, it will be put in here. So how the calculation, like how this 55 came actually. So you can see this is the formula actually. So what is the formula? The input. So the input size minus the filter or kernel size divided by stride and plus one. So you can say this is the basic formula. So input is 27. Input is 27, right? So 227 minus of what? Minus of filter. Filter size is 11. So minus filter size is 11 divided by the stride. Stride we have taken 4. So 4. Then what will be the outcome? Plus 1. So it will give you 55. So this is nothing but that particular calculation based. So it will give you the 55 cross 55 images with as we are applying 96 kernels. So it will give you 96 extracted features, right? Then it will pass through the overlapping mechanism. Why we call it overlapping? It actually overlaps. So what happened? Suppose we are taking 5 cross 5. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we have taken 5 cross 5. So we have taken 5 cross 5 here. So 5 cross 5 image. So what it does? 3 cross 3, the pooling will be applied. 3 cross 3. So the pooling, max pooling means, so whatever the pixel values here, so it will do the 3 cross 3. It will be the maximum pooling, and whatever inside this pixel, it will extract the maximum value, right? So again, stride is 2, nothing but it will just move 1, 2. It will move 2 columns, like 2 stride, then it will apply here, right? So there will be overlapping, means this part is overlapped, right? You can say if it moved 2 stride. So it is nothing but that overlapping, it is saying about overlapping. So how it got into 27, let's see. That same formula will be applied. So and like input size is 55, as it came from this side is 55 image. So 55 minus filter size is, filter is nothing but that particular pooling. So pooling 3 cross 3 has been applied. So minus 3 divided by the stride, and divided by the stride 2, so plus 1. So it will give you 27. So that particular pooling is applied on the 96 extract images. So we'll get the 96 extracted images with 27 cross 27. Again, that particular extracted images, this is nothing but I was talking about responded normalization. So I'll talk about this later. So again, it will go to the convolution layer. Convolution layer is nothing but we have to apply filters, 5 cross 5 filters with padding 2. So why padding is done here? Like, we have to create many more overlaps as possible. So padding is nothing but, if you delete all, so padding is nothing but if we have some 3 cross 3 image. Suppose we have 3 cross 3 image and we are applying padding 2. Padding 2 is nothing but it will just add 2 more columns and 2 more rows. So this is two more column and two more rows. One, two. Right, it will just add it up this in the front and like in the right side and left side both. Right, it should add. So my image, sorry for my image, like I can't draw it properly. I have to get my pen. So till then, please try to cope up. So 3 cross 3 image, we have to add padding, and in that particular padding, we have to use 0 cross, like all the padding, new padding pixels, we have to apply 0 here. So what happens? 3 cross 3, like 3 cross 3 was there. Then if you applied two padding is equal to 2, so this one is increased. The pixel size will be increased, right? Here 2 and here 2. So 4 increase. So after using padding, it will turn into 7 cross 7. So why it is saying, like why we used to do padding? So if you do more padding, and we have applied kernel size suppose 3 cross 3, so the edge so if you do strat is equal to, the overlap will happen. So originally the 3 cross 3 image is here. So originally this is the 3 cross 3 image, right? So if you use padding, and on that particular thing, if you apply the filters, so these features, this edge, like we need to concentrate on edges. So the important edges will be considered, like it will be overlapped in that particular edges, so that we can extract important features from the edges of the image. Like so this will be overlap if you use padding. So padding is, this is like this is where padding is useful. So padding is gone. Then like after padding or same overlap pooling is like how the calculation happens in the padding. Let's see. You have used 20 cross, like 27. So 27, in that 27, if you use padding is equal to 2, so let's consider this is 20 cross 7, like 27. So 27 cross 27. So in that particular 27 cross 27, we are adding padding 2, means we have to add another 2 column and another 2 rows down. So 4 will be increased. So 27 will turn into 31. So in that particular 31 cross 31, we have to add 5 cross 5 filter. So 31 minus 5 divided by the stride. Here stride is taken as 1, divided by 1 plus 1. So it will come at 27.